We gather under your cloud, O Lord, this afternoon, expectant that will surely open this floodgate. Holy Spirit, we look up to heaven, we look up to you. We are gathered under this cloud that the Papa indeed will open the floodgate. Yes, Lord, we receive. We receive. We receive of you, Father. We say, Lord, let Jesus be glorified this afternoon. Let him be glorified this afternoon. Let him show up again in his characteristics. Let him be glorified here this afternoon. Thank you. Thank you for the word. Thank you for the grace. Thank you for the mercy. Thank you for the worship. We give you praise, Lord. Yes, Lord, we know no other one but you, Jesus. The King of glory, the Lord of glory. The one that rules in the affairs of men. The one that sits upon the circle of the earth. We know no other one but you. Thank you, Father. We give you honor. In the name of Jesus. And amen.
Amen.
Oh, give God the praise, God. God bless you. Let me say, God bless you. God bless you all. Thank you for that worship. May the Lord increase your grace, anointing, and may He refresh you for that which has gone out of you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to appreciate our pastors. Pastor Kemi Abidogun, you are welcome. God bless you. We are happy to have you in this today. It's very encouraging. We want to thank the family also that has come with you. You are welcome in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And I want to thank the members that have chosen to be consistent with the doing of the Lord in this place. God bless you all.
Amen.
The Lord indeed is a faithful God. We will be preaching together, let's do it together, not just one man. How many of us here can say you have friends? Please let me see your hand. You have friends. I'm not talking about I say that you have friends, I'm not talking about acquaintance. You can say boldly, you can beat your chest, I have friends. At least there is one I know. This one is my friend. Let me see your hands. Are you sure? Yeah. Praise God. I don't have fellow preachers here today. Now, you will know between you and your friends, sometimes things are not always close as you expect. Is that not so? Your friends offend. Is that not so? And sometimes it's kind of a wow, you know, I told you I'm a friend. I know he will disappoint. Praise the Lord. Let's look at the scripture together. Hallelujah.
Amen.
John chapter 15. John 15. Are we there? All right. Look at verse 15, where our Lord Jesus was talking, and this time around he was addressing those that belonged to him. Hello? You okay? John 15, verse 15. Look at what it says. He said, henceforth, from now on, I no longer call you servant. But what do I call you? Now, because a servant does not know what his master is doing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But I have called you what?
Friends.
Why? For all things that I have from my Father, I have made known unto you. Have you ever pondered on this word before? I was asking my daddy, your God, yesterday, what do I have to do? He said, let them know they are my friends. And I remain their friend.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Now, in friendship, you want to define who a friend is. A friend, you must get to know, because if you don't understand what you are into, to operate becomes a bit of a difficulty for you. Okay? So, when we want to define what or who a friend is, A friend is a person you like and you support. Somebody you like, you've been together, you like him because, and you like her because, you know, we, I remember when I went to propose to my wife, don't laugh. She asked me two questions. I was confused. You love me. I was wondering if I don't love you, I wouldn't have come to you. I didn't say that so that she doesn't write me off. I said, I love you. And then she went on and said, do you like me? My job dropped. I'm serious. I'm not being funny. I'm just being serious. Then, not quite long ago anyway, that was 1985, I couldn't distinguish between love and like. Praise the Lord. But now, I understand better. When you say, do you like, when she asked me, do you like me? There are certain things I didn't like at all. But I always remember that question. Do you like me? So what I do is to cover that area. Are you with me?
Yes.
To make sure we flow. And the Lord will speak to you.
Amen.
Okay, that's one. Then, a friend, someone that is warm and very pleasant. Somebody that is warm and very pleasant. Look at, as I'm talking, look at those who are truly your friends. When I say friends, I'm not talking of somebody that is talking about you behind you. I'm not talking of somebody that who rejoices at your calamity, at your peace. I'm talking of friends. You may have those acquaintances. They can do any other thing. When it comes to fresh, I'm talking of somebody that is warm and easy to be approached. Very pleasant. Oh, no wonder. No wonder what that sister said to me, when I met you, I had the solution to that problem. I'm talking of friends. And then, you can also give it a definition that a person that is not harmful in any way, not harmful, in any little way, listen to me, even when he hurts you, oh, I remember one time in Asia, I did something not too good. I didn't know it wasn't too good. Then I went to this my friend, and I narrated my story to him. So, why do I have to do that? My heart hurt because I was expecting something else. Something that will come for me. My heart hurt. But each time up till now, since 1984, 86, each time I remember that man, that was a good friend of mine. Because all of that person might comfort you, might call you, and the one that tells you the story, the reality, the truth, the one that loves you. That's a good friend. Are you with me?
Yes.
Okay, fine. Let's take our step by law. Then the person who looks after your interests when you are not around, when you are around, when you don't know something is wrong behind at your back, there's someone that is watching at your back. You don't even know. Now, excuse me. Whom do you want to put in this category of friends? Among all your friends, whom do you want to put there? Huh? I guess you don't have friends. Some people are not even sure. People say, you don't have friends in this place. No wonder he asked me to tell you I'm your friend. It's only Jesus that has occupied that shoe. Jesus, your Savior, sent me to you. So tell them, I am your friend. So, okay. But let's look at some characteristics of friendship. I've just shared one with you in Proverbs. Look at Proverbs 28. It says, faithful are the wounds of friends. The wound from a friend does more good. How many of us agree with me? It might hurt you. Whatever he's going to say to you might hurt you. Might be something you don't want to hear. But there's a reason. He's the only one that can. The brother was with me a few days ago. Share with me some little problem we had with wife. And I said, why don't you look at it this way? Why don't you look at this? Why about you this way? Why about you that way? He said, among everybody I've ever been talking to, you always slice it. with knife. He says, and it is. Meanwhile, this man said, no more. I'm going away. I don't want to forget my wife. Say, look at it. Look at this. Look at this. This way. And then he came back to his senses. Because we are friends. Are you with me? Listen to me. Your pastor was a God. Your father was a release. But what you don't understand is this. Except a seed falls and dies, it abides alone. Remember the message he gave me last week for you? I said, be prepared. Is that not so?
Yes.
Be prepared for what?
For
be prepared for work. Except what I have come to notice in the operations of God. And I want to prompt us your ears, open your heart, and get this thing right. And that is why I thank you very much, sir, for what you said when you are ranking up. He said, the time for play is gone. The time for everybody on his own is gone. No one to be at that place now. No one to be here. No one to be here. Just one man doing everything. Those days are what? They are gone. The same thing happened to Jesus and his disciples. By the time he left, everybody ran away. They wanted to hide it. They only came out when they were hungry. But Peter said, I go a fishing again. Because no more money. The wife has been pulling him. No more money. How do we eat? And Peter said, I go to fish. And he said, he said, we have got to fish. We are tired of all this thing. Initially they were afraid. They went to hide it. Fear can never help you guys. No. Your staying at home will never help you guys. But I have come to tell you the mind of the master. Not until after Jesus Christ himself died, the fruit never came up. And when he was telling them all these stories, he didn't know. You see, by the way, that's one thing I need to remind you. How many of us remember the story of our father in the Lord here in April, the Easter message? Go back to YouTube. And listen to that message. He was telling you that there are people who don't know. It was my wife that called my attention to that. He was telling you the same way God made sure he blocked the mind of the disciples not to understand the meaning of what Jesus was saying. God blocked your mind. And he was going. Go and listen to that message again. It's in YouTube. Is somebody here? After all, he wasn't sick. Let us not be people that are slow in understanding. So, Jesus kept on saying, I'm going. Didn't understand. Thomas kept on asking some questions. What does it mean? This is why you see me. People that you don't see me. What's all these things that you say? You know me. And then at the time, he said to them, okay, let me talk to you. I'm going to die. This is what will happen. He said, yes, now you are talking to us. Are you not happy that I'm telling you the truth? Okay, fine. When the time comes, you will scatter. Mm. And when the time came, what happened? They scattered. How many empty seats can you count here? Hello? Is that the solution?
No.
Is that the solution?
No.
They said, I should tell you, you know my friends. What I have done to you might be hurting to you now is for your own good. Because something's about to spark up from this ministry.
Amen.
I'm repeating because I know. Same thing he told us last week. When a seed falls down, what does it happen? It terminates and brings forth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And not until when the people continue to pray under the same roof, on the platform of unity and the meekness of their heart, nothing happened. It was not when Peter sat at home and said, help me check, is John at the prayer meeting before I come? Or how many people are at the prayer meeting today? Oh, it is raining. Oh, it is winter time. No, the Bible says, when they came together, and they pray, hallelujah, because their friends have promised them that he will never leave them alone.
nor forsake them.
That was when the power came. You want to see that revival? It's not going to be on your bedroom. It's not going to be when you are doing extra work for extra pastoring. Because a revival is about to break forth.
Amen.
I'm telling you. God your father said to me, said, I am your friend. Let's look at one other thing. The Bible says a friend is always friendly at all times. Proverbs 18:24. Jesus never denied his friendship. And then in the book of Proverbs, that makes us understand that if you want to be friend, you must be friendly. You want to be friend? You must be friendly. No, you can't just be at home doing your own thing and you want your house to become the church. No, it will not happen. It will never happen. You will have to make up your mind to be part of the friendliness, to be one to Christ. To respond to his dealings, to his chastisement, to be among your brethren. He said, by this shall all men know that you belong to me if you have love one for another. How do we have love one for another? To the fellowship of phone calls? It doesn't work. Nonetheless, your father sent me to you. He said, tell them, they are my friends. And I'm their friends.
Okay. In our friendship with him, there's something that he did that only him determines how we must do our own. The Bible says, a friend laid down his life. Is that also? Jesus laid down his life for us. Not for the Father, but for us. He chose to say, come and kill me because of these people. In fact, when he was arrested at the garden, and he knew that these people would be affected, he said, look, if it is me that you are looking for, let these people go first. And they let them go. And then he put himself in that position. And then he was arrested. And every other thing happened. But thank God that even the one that denied him and ran away, by the time he resurrected, he was the first he remembered. He said, tell my disciples, including Peter. Why? Because that is friendship. A friend does not neglect his other friend, even on the face of serious disappointment. Jesus could have been disappointed and said, well, I'm done with you, Peter, because exactly what you did was what Judas Iscariot did for you. He didn't say that. But when he came back, he said, go and tell my disciples. And all that I've said to them, I've come to pass. So please pick up. Don't forget Peter. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't forget Harry.
Said, ye are my friends. A leader.
And so he said, as many of you that want to be my disciple, what do?
You carry your cross every day. Every day. Every day. Every day. You see, let me tell you something here. Let me tell you a story here.
I don't know whether I'm the only one that has the kind of heart. I don't know. But let me tell you something here. What is death?
Oh, God.
We are the seems to be animating this guy. Between 94 and 98 or 99, this guy came to me 6 times. I saw him. I can tell you how death looked like. It's a spirit. Though he felt it, the first 3 times I shook. I was afraid. But by the 4th time, I said, yeah, I'm ready to go. Come. That's my wife. She's like, come. So it's like by the 5th and the 6th time, he just stopped coming. When he saw my boldness, who are you? Of recent, 2016, if you don't mind me sharing this, I don't usually share, I've not spoken it, I've seen it for the first time now. I was caught up again, and I was shown something glorious. I was actually there, and I entered. And I asked questions, how glorious it will be if other things happen. He said, well, leave that for. And I was taken back. Then my angel came later and said to me, a period of darkness is coming. I didn't understand that. I wish I had understood. Between 2015 and 2015 and this year, twice I've been rushed to hospital. In fact, my problem, it was very late before it was diagnosed, and I'm still on the medication. Then, in the midst of it, my sister died. 2 months after, my mother died. I said, God, am I really supposed to be again in this world? Do you understand? I want you to get the picture. The pain was all over my heart. And then when I go up, you see Stephen with smile on my face. Is that not so? You know why? Because we must carry our cross every day. Him alone determine the cross we must carry. It is not you that determine the cross we must carry. Because you see, my friend will not let me down. His name is Jesus. Look, there's something that is waiting for you and I over there. Your eyes cannot describe it. Your mouth cannot see how it looks like. There is nothing, because no, the Bible says so. Go to your book and read the Bible, and because I also saw. You can't. I want to use Paul Stanley to lose that. Yeah. Even the pounds have gone down, bruh. When people say they want to come to Britain these days, I said to them, we are not just feeding the food, we are feeding the sandwiches. And the crumbs that are falling on the ground is feeding off, is getting off. So you come, just come for nothing. It is hunger that will drive you back. Am I lying? Preached a message 10 years ago, 11 years ago. I said, God said he will visit this nation and he turn your money to preach this. They look at me and said, you are too hard in your preaching. I said, okay, no problem, I'm sorry. Now they know. I said, all this is your benefit. Somebody is coming to get them off. How many benefits do we have now? Eh? Now they said, we will make you to do what you can do, not what you cannot do. That was what they said 5 or 6 years ago. Is that also when they came in? Now they said, we are not going to talk of austerity anymore. That was last week. Because they don't have answer anymore. They send it on the telly, and we don't know answer anymore. You know why? Because they don't have the answer. God is shaking nations to their foundations. He's shaking them to let them know they don't own this world. The Bible says he rules in their fears of men. And you want to join in the shaking? When God shakes, though, you have no respect or regard for anybody. Brethren, let's wake up. It's time for work. It is time for everybody to be more serious in their own, you know, to in this or her department. To say, yeah, let me remove my jacket. Pastor, what do I do? What do I do? Mama, give us something, give us a leader. Whom do we follow? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because when Moses, my servant, was there, Joshua came into place. Give us somebody. And at this place, no matter what, it will not die.
Amen.
My daughter, my spirit is saying, oh boy. When we started 1993, the ministry in Nigeria, by 1994, God said, I send the youth to you. The whole place flooded with the youth. Between 60 or 70% of them, as of today, have become pastors or pastors' wife at various areas. One of them happened to be my daughter, is pastor, his husband. Her husband is now pastoring the church we left in Nigeria. And then, a month ago, when we were talking, the husband said he's going. You know what the wife said? He said, me, I am so moved to this ministry. If my husband said he wants to go, well, I want to when God speaks to me. He said, remember what I told you, Daddy, 2004? He said, this ministry is my ministry.
Amen.
We are looking for people.
Amen.
Eh?
Yes.
I will have a God and say, this ministry is our ministry.
Yeah.
I go nowhere.
Amen.
That is it. And they are here. We are here. Are you with me?
Yes.
We are here. We are here. You are, when I listen to your leaders, the qualities of words, what their own words and God's were coming out of their mouth, I said, Lord, you have products in this place. So, what is Jesus demanding from us? That's number one. Number two, let's look at 1 John. And then I'm writing up. 1 John. Book of 1 John. Because you see, friendship is in two ways. Is that also? If you want to be friendly, you want to have friends, you must be friendly. So, let's look at what he's saying. Because friendship has rules. I mean, so I agree with me that friendship has rules. Eh? There are rules of friendship. You don't know there are rules. The way I relate with you, my acquaintance, is different from the way I relate with my friends. There's a prayer partner I've been having since 1989. We still pray together on phone. And whatever God said to me, speak to him immediately. Our spirits have linked together. We have been covenanted together without him with grace saying it. So, friendship. So, me too, I don't neglect him. I pray for him. I pray with him. I'm careful about what belongs to him. So, let's look at 1 John chapter 1. 1 John chapter 1. Look at what it says. Now, I thought somebody has opened that for me. 1 John chapter 1. Are we there? Okay, let me read from verse 3. He said, that which we have seen, mark that one. And that which we have heard, please mark that, is what we declare unto you. Why? So that you also may have what? Fellowship with us. And truly, our fellowship will be with the Father and His Son, Jesus Christ. Fellowship. That fellowship, the Father doesn't joke with it. And that's what has brought success to your Father in the Lord. That's what makes success of any minister of God. Fellowship. Because you see, if you do not have heart to heart together, do you know some friends, unless you are not afraid to pour all of your heart to them. How many of us agree with that? The thing that sometimes, occasionally, you cannot discourage your husband, which is not supposed to do, but because you are so close, you've been together before you got married, your friendship has been tested and been tried. While from primary school, everything has been, you understand me, you fought in set settle, you've done this, you've done that. And there is nothing that you cannot. It's so amazing how such friendship developed. And God is saying something here. In the midst of fellowshipping, that's when we discover ourselves. If you love God, or you truly want to discover who God is, befriend, have fellowship with Him. The people that wrote this says, look, you know our secret? Our secret was that we have fellowship with Him. We have heard about Him. The pastor that preached about Him all the while He was in our midst. His wife also said the same thing about Jesus. But now He said to us, let us go and discover that Jesus ourselves. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Woo! Did you get that message? Yes. Let's go and discover that Jesus Himself. To let us know whether what He has said is true or not. That the people will be real. Let's go. And you can only do that when you create a period for fellowship between you and Jesus. Jesus asked me to tell you again, you are His friends.
Yeah.
And the friendship between you and Him will remain solid.
Yeah.
And unchanged. Because you see, it is in the fellowshipping that He will give you instruction that you are going to obey. Yeah? Are you with me? He said, happy are you if you know this thing and you do them. He said, abide in me and I will abide in you. Is that not so? He said, you can only, a branch does not stand on its own. He said, the only thing that can make you to be fruitful and be productive is only when you abide in me. And He said, Father, I pray not only for these 12 or these 11 that are remaining, I pray for as many that will believe through them. Oh, my goodness.
Amen.
And He said, let not your heart be troubled. He said, believe in me, believe also in God, because in my Father's house, what? And many mansions. Say, if it were not so, not a lie, I would have told you. And I go therefore to prepare a place for you. And if I have gone to prepare for you, I'm also coming back. Oh, God. Can my Jesus ever lie?
No.
I tell you some situation around me, say, I'm still handing my microphone. Oh, yeah. Because I have burned the bridges. You know the meaning of when you burn the bridges? Eh? When you have a girlfriend in the past as a non-believer. Eh? But when you have a girlfriend or a man friend, and when you are a non-believer, and now you are married to the right person, what do? You burn the bridges. So you are not tempted to look back. Because when you look back, you see her face again. She's so beautiful. How can man see that? So, no, you won't. When you look back, there's no more bridge for you.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
How many of us have said Jesus is our friend?
Yes.
Well, let's start on our feet, okay? I don't want us to. Let's start on our feet. I want us to review individually our friendship with you. Do we really, with your own mouth or with your own heart, believe that Jesus is your friend? Come on, I want us individually to examine ourselves. How much of friendship are you to Jesus? How much of it? What can you really say your relationship with it is with Him now? And what is your plan after today for this ministry? Discuss it with Him. If you want to say, Jesus, actually, no, I don't have any plan for this ministry, I don't understand, I want to work in it. Fine, good. And if you want to say to Him, Lord, I need you to help me. I believe you have sent me here for a purpose. And that purpose will be accomplished. Come on. I want you to individually talk to God. I want us to talk to God. I'm not going to ask you to pray this prayer, pray that prayer. No, no, no. This is the time to talk to God. It's a personal thing. It's a personal thing. Just talk to Him. Now come on, have a discussion with Him. Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for what you are doing. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, glory, 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 glory. Let's just bow our heart. Let's bow our heart to God. Let's say, God, this is my weakness. I just need your help. This is the area I'm lacking. Maybe there are some things on the eye to be dot on the cross. Lord, I need you. Help me do all these things. Oh, glory to God. What are you doing? Lord, concerning those that have gone, those who have one leg out. What are you doing about them? The Bible says we should carry one another's body. What are you doing? Hallelujah. What are you doing? What promise are you making to God that God, from this moment, this sister so and so, this brother so and so, God, I will be on my knees until you are restored. Hallelujah. Let's Let's just give God. Let's talk to God. Let's have a personal discussion with Him. Hallelujah. Oh, glory, 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 glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus, we pray.
Amen.
Let's just pray. Father, you spoke to me and tell them I'm still their friends.
Amen.
And that they are your friends. Amen. You call them friends, not servants anymore. He said, a servant does not know the mind of the master. But you have revealed your mind to us because you made us your friends. Lord, these two things I'm asking of you. We have let go. We have sown our Father in the Lord as you see in your kingdom. Your word will not be denied.
Amen.
You cannot deny your word. Whatever a man sows, he will reap. Father, by the seed of faith and of life, wherein we have sown, visit our seed.
Amen.
Father, visit our seed.
Amen.
Watch over the seed yourself.
Amen.
As you watch over the seed of your son.
Amen.
And as your son declared to us, except a seed fall down and die, it abided alone. Father, we pray at your words. We have sown this seed. By faith we declare it is a seed of life for the purpose of the kingdom. Therefore, we demand let there be multiplication of life back to us. Let there be restoration of life back to us. Let there be multiplication of life back to us. Let there be multiplication of life back to us. Now let them come even without measure. In good measure, brethren, and shake it together. Let there be an overflowing of life. And Christ divine ministry. In the name of Jesus. Second thing I'm asking of you, Father. The Bible says understanding belongs to you. As many of your people that are still lacking in understanding, they don't know. They are asking questions. Despite your word that you have been sending to them. Father Lord, let them have an encounter with you.
Amen.
Father, we declare in this ministry, it shall not be said that after you have taken our Father in the Lord to yourself, it is closed down. No, we cancel that by the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Then it shall be said, hallelujah, that Lord, you visited your people, you answered their outcry, and you attend to their demand, and then you brought forth even multiplication of souls in this ministry, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are a God of strategy. The leadership beginning from your daughter, our mother in the Lord. Father, Lord, begin to speak to them in their visions, in their dreams, the way forward. He said to Joshua, Moses, my servant, is there. Arise and lead these people to the promised land. And Joshua fulfill it. Lord, who is the Joshua you have given to us, Father? Lord, we are the Kenneth. Begin to rise them up, Father. Let them take their responsibility. Let them arise from their responsibility. And let them do the work of the ministry. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Give them victory without much strength over their enemies. And they possess every area you want them to possess. Even the kings that rose up against them, Father, by the word of your mouth they spoke. Lord, the five kings were destroyed. Father, we pray before this altar as some people arise to begin to walk. Every resistance will resist them. Every resistance will resist them. Every resistance will resist them. We say, Father, whatever they are called, we demand at the name of Jesus, every nation bow. That is what you have said, both on earth or in heaven, wherever it may be. We command them, therefore, to submit even to the name of the Lord Jesus, to submit to the counsel of our Father. We bring destruction to them as your people begin to arise and begin to do the work of the gospel. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, we shall not labor for long before we get results. Yes, Lord, in this ministry, by the time we get results, people will say, oh my God, this is the finger of the Lord.
Amen.
Father, we want to we want to be coming every week for testimony.
Amen.
And everyone that are blessed, Father, will reopen our door. Let them come in by the power of that spirit.
Amen.
Lord, open their eyes, give them understanding in the name of the Lord Jesus. We pray not only for ourselves in this name, we pray for ourselves in both. We say, Lord, let the counsel of the Lord begin to prevail. Let the man of God be unveiled in the name of the Lord Jesus. We give you all the glory and praise. Blessed be your name forever. In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
And amen. Praise the Lord.
Glory be to God, church. Shall we thank the Lord for the life of our Father in the Lord, Reverend Henry Emmanuel? Let's say thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you for using the man of God to speak to my heart today. Oh, Lord, I bless you. I bless you. I bless you, precious Father. Just let your glory come upon him. Let more anointing reach him. Replace that which was lost in the name of Jesus. Use it more and more for your glory, precious Lord. Daddy, we thank you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Shall we be seated, church? Oh, I'm so happy to be here today. Amen.
Amen.
Is anybody sad in the house? Ah, that's it. Come on, Christ divine. Talk to me. How are we today? How are we today? Did I hear somebody give God glory for the life of Pastor Kenny Abidogun? Thank you. God bless you. God bless you. Our God is great. You know what? I've been to Bolton today. I spent 1 hour with them, and I was determined to be here today because I'm back to work. Amen?
Amen.
Thank you, every one of you. I love you guys. You are great. Thank you for standing with me through the thick and the thin periods. You were there. I know there are some of our brothers that are not here today, but they have not gone away.
No.
They are just not in church today.
Yeah.
I know we will not lose a single person.
Amen.
In Christ divine.
Amen.
Rather, the door is open for many more that are waiting in the wings to come in.
Amen.
And we are ready to take them on. Right? Amen.
Amen.
Let me tell you this. In these last 2 weeks, I died and I resurrected. The God that did it for me has done it for you.
Amen.
Because I believe you all died with me when we lost Pastor Kenny.
Yes.
Amen? But God has resurrected us again.
Amen.
Because the Lord has given me an understanding which I'm passing on to you today. Pastor Kenny did not die. Can a believer die?
No.
What do we believe in? Is it the word of God? Or the tradition of men? We believe the word of God. And the word of God states it very clearly in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13. Apostle Paul, our father, talked to us. He said, look, I don't want you to believe like ignorant men that have no hope about the dead. Because those who are in Christ, they do not die. They sleep. The other word for sleep, I would say it is like transfer. You've been transferred to this plane, to the outer realm, to the heavenly realm.
Amen.
You know, I thought about this in my mind, and the Lord gave me an understanding. And it's amazing that the Lord used an experience that I went through when I was still working in the secular world to help me to understand it. I want to share it with you today. You know, when I was still working in the secular world, I have one very beautiful manager, very good man. We're a team, quite a big team. And this man took care of us very well. But there came a time in the organization when they needed this man. He has peculiar skills. He is very knowledgeable. He's full of wisdom. So they needed him for a special project. And out of the whole organization, they singled him out. And they told him, we have to take you out from being the team leader so that you can run this project for us in the headquarters. Oh, we were not happy with that. We said, why? Why? Why our leader? Can't they choose somebody else? In the headquarters, don't they have enough people? Amen?
Amen.
But you see, this man didn't want to go either because he loved his team. We were one together. Amen?
Amen?
We call him by name. We have tea together. But he had to go because he had been summoned from the headquarters. You can't say no to the leaders, to the chief executive, to the directors in the headquarters. When they say move, you have to what? Jump. In fact, you jump and run. You have to move. So they took him away. And initially we were sad. But then we came to understand something. That is not that he died. He's just been transferred. He has been promoted. And we that he has left behind, we should become proud of him. Because it shows that he's a peculiar person. He's a wonderful person. God's child. Anointed. Carrying peculiar skills that is needed. Not just for the benefit of our team, but for the benefit of the whole organization, so that the organization can prosper. Beloved, your Pastor Kenny did not die.
Amen.
He's just been transferred to headquarters.
Amen.
Because his skills are needed. He has become an ambassador of the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
No longer of Christ divine,
Amen.
But the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
If you understand the word of God, it says we are like angels in the kingdom. Angels are what? Special messengers of grace. So that means he has now gone on to carry a special assignment. It might be that he might send it to you one day in your time of need.
Amen.
But one thing you can rest assured, he will always have favor on Christ the Father. So I don't want to hear anyone mourning anymore. Promise me that?
Yeah.
No more mourning. No more sorrow. No more crying. I want you to rejoice. That the Son of God has gone home, but he's not sleeping, he's doing greater works.
Amen.
And we that is left behind, we are proud of him.
Amen.
So we take forward what he has taught us, and we are going to march forward. Amen?
Amen.
And possess our possession.
Amen.
Christ divine, I say it is well with you.
Amen.
Arise and shine.
Amen.
For greater is he who lives in you.
Amen.